The A-Series network video recorders from Exacq provide a versatile range of options and are some of the most popular choices for most users. When unpacking your exacqVision A-Series system, you will find an insert containing a QR code to the online quick start guide, a mouse and keyboard, rack mount rails, a tray containing the video storage hard drives, and finally, a box containing the server itself. The server box holds power cords, a box containing the front bezel and hardware, and your new exacqVision A-Series server. Choosing the best model for your deployment will be largely based on your storage and configuration needs. The A-Series 2A and 2A Hybrid provide JBOD storage, while the A-Series FA and FAR models provide the ability to hot swap storage drives in RAID 5 and RAID 6 arrays. 2A and 2A Hybrid units provide 8GB of RAM, upgradable to 16GB, while FA and FAR units start at 16GB and are upgradable to 32GB of RAM. Each provide dedicated 256GB SSDs, separating the operating system from video storage, with the FAR offering dual SSDs in a mirrored RAID 1 configuration for operating system fault tolerance. In addition to dual OS drives, the FAR also features redundant power supplies. Each A-Series model is available with Ubuntu Linux or Windows operating systems to suit the preference for your site. The front-facing ports on each system include two USB Type-A 3.1 ports. Looking at the rear, the 2A and 2A hybrid systems provide two USB Type-A 3.2 ports, two USB Type-A 2.0 ports, two serial RS-232 interfaces, two display ports, one HDMI port, and one VGA interface, as well as 3.5mm mic in and line out audio ports. The 2A hybrid also provides an LFH interface. When used with the included multi-headed BNC cable, this provides inputs for analog cameras. Beside this are I/O pins used for input triggers and output alarms. The FA and FAR models also provide five USB Type-A 3.2 ports, one USB Type-C port, two serial RS-232 interfaces, one display port, one HDMI port, and one VGA interface, as well as a 3.5mm mic in, and line out port. On top of the mirrored operating system SSDs, the FAR model provides redundant power supplies for high availability. All models provide two 2.5 gigabit per second network ports. To rack mount the system, begin by using the blue release to separate the inner rail from the outer rail. The outer rail is evident by a release pole and pegs at each end. To attach the inner rail to the chassis, locate the chassis pegs which correspond to the slots in the rail. Slide these into the slot openings and push the rail towards the rear of the system to click it into place. The small M4 screws included can be used on each side to further secure the inner rail to the system chassis, preventing any shifting or rattling. If you should ever need to remove or reposition the inner rail, remove the M4 screw and pull the locking tab out while sliding the rail forward. The outer rails attach to your server rack and support racks with square or unthreaded round mounting holes. Find a location in your server rack with enough space for the system. Align the pegs with the corresponding holes in the rack. Pull out the spring-loaded metal tab, push them into place, and release the tab. Do this again on the other end of the rail. Repeat these steps for the opposite side. Should you need to remove the rails, pull the release tabs outward to separate from the rack. With both rails secured in the rack, pull the blue slide release on the inner rails while inserting the inner rails into the outer rails and pushing the system in towards the rack. Lift the screw covers on each side and turn the screws to fix the system to the rack. Insert the included power cables and plug in all power supplies on the server. For uninterrupted operation, we recommend providing power with an appropriately sized UPS. Because the server ships with the video storage hard drives separately packaged, you will need to add the drives to the system before powering on. Remove each storage drive from its protective sleeve. Each drive is pre-installed in the drive caddy. Press the drive caddy button to release the locking latch. The server drive bays are numbered left to right, beginning with the lower left-hand corner as pictured. Any of the drives shipped with the system may be used in any order, but you will insert them beginning with slot 1 and progressing until all drives have been used. With the drive caddy latch open, insert it into the slot and press in until it clicks. Ensure the latch interlocks with the slot opening to be certain the drive is well connected to the backplane. Repeat these steps for each drive. Allow a few minutes for system startup. When starting up for the first time, you will be prompted to set up the operating system administrator account and password. You will then be prompted to create a username and password for the exacqVision software admin account. Once these steps have been completed, open the exacqVision client software using the exacqVision icon on the desktop. Select the cogwheel icon in the upper corner to navigate to configuration mode. From the left-hand navigation tree, select Configure System beneath the system name. Use the Network tab to configure your system interfaces. We recommend using the Management interface for client connections and reaching the internet, and using the Data interfaces to isolate your cameras. Purchase of an A-Series system includes 8 free camera licenses for any supported camera, but the system must have a license applied to begin adding your cameras. Users with supported models of Illustra IQ cameras may make use of the exacqVision Advantage program, which provides free licensing for Illustra IQ Flex and Pro models, up to the maximum number of IP streams supported by your NVR. Claim these licenses from exacq.com prior to applying the license key. Move to the System tab to apply your license key. If the system has internet access, you may select the From Exacq.com option from the Import button. If your system does not have internet access, you may upload a license key file or enter the key manually in the license field above. When licensed and connected to your network, you are ready to begin adding devices and configuring your system. Refer to our support portal and online documentation for greater details.